12-year-old border collie. It's a family dog. He lives with my parents and does a lot of stuff around the house with them. But he also does a lot of stuff with me. He's my camping dog, canoeing dog, agility, sniffer dog. And in the past, he's been able to come to work with me. So that's really nice.
Oliver, go tell him.
I'm in my early 60s, and I've had multiple sclerosis for almost 30 years. Some difficulties with my mobility and vision and so forth. But we're still getting out and about, and Asher helps me out.
Thanks, sweetheart. Thank you. Very good dog.
So my dad's had a knee replacement and a hip replacement, and has a lot of troubles with arthritis and with pain. Walks with a cane and things like that.
You pick it up. Take it to Mama. You take it to Mama. Hi, Ash. Come up. Thank you, sweetheart. Thank you.
It's really important that he's well-trained, that my dad can go to the park and literally move like 4 feet from the car, and Asher has superb recall and will be able to go and have miles of running, but can come right back when it's time to get back in the car.
The wonderful thing as my mobility got worse and worse is that he's so independent. Wait. All I need to do is get it to the top of the stairs in the backyard.
Hold on.
And I just give him various commands.
Good boy.
He loves learning.
Go by. Now go along. Go along. Go along. Oh.
We always had dogs when I was a child. So I knew from very young that you could train a dog to do anything. And got my first dog, who was a first cross border collie, rough coat collie, when I was in college.
I was grew up a cat person, but then I met this wonderful woman who had a collie border collie cross named George, and he was an adorable puppy. In order to get the dog, I married the woman.
When we first got Asher, Harriet was here living with us. She went to work every day at a training facility for people with physical and mental difficulties. Asher went too, and he learned a lot there, and she started to take him to agility classes and disc dog, and he also did herding lessons.
Here, so over this jump, and then right. Okay, start.
We love dog training. We've done a lot of research on clicker training and shaping, and we took classes from wonderful people for years. And so we basically used the tricks and the natural skills that we learned in classes, and we just transferred them to life skills.
Oh, Ashley, pick it up.
So he helps clean my mom's room, takes her socks off at night, brings messages back and forth within the house. If she falls down, he's going to be able to alert someone for help.
It wasn't hard to train Asher, and I find that if you incorporate 5 minutes a day teaching him something new or working on something, he loves that.
Tug, 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 tug. Take, tug, tug, tug. Good boy, Asher. Good boy. Take the other one. Tug, tug. Good boy, honey.
Nothing we have trained Asher is genius level at all. It's really just taking basic things that he naturally likes to do and kind of looking creatively at how can he do them.
Here, Asher. Take it to Angus. Take it to Angus.
Oh, hi, Ashy. Good boy. Good boy. Oh, here. You take this to Mom.
We have another daughter, Phoebe, who's, though she doesn't live even in the city, is a big part of Asher's life. She was with us when we picked him, and she's been around a lot. Now she lives in Montreal. To Asher, rather, she's just fun in a big bundle, and when she arrives, life is exciting.
I'm a teacher, and I literally am out of the house for about 12 hours each day, most of the days. For me, this is great, because I have a dog that I know I don't have to worry about during the day, but can keep up with me when I'm doing all of the stuff I like to do on the weekends. And I'm really involved in helping my parents as well. So it's a really nice thing that brings us together.
The most useful thing I think that Asher does for me is he picks things up. I'm in a wheelchair a lot. It's hard to lift, pick up things from a wheelchair. When I'm out on my scooter, it's just really nice to have him with me. And he is useful.
Having had in the family multiple sclerosis for 30 years, one thing I can tell you is that we have filled out a number of surveys, government questionnaires in relation to medical relief and planning. What I write in every single one of those times is how an animal, almost any animal, can make a difference for someone who's ill.
He's certainly not a service dog, Although I wish he could wear a little coat and people would let him in stores and so forth, because I often go on errands and I can't take him. He is certainly therapy to the whole family, because he's basically this joyful creature that makes us all smile. So he's as much of a therapy dog as any other dog, but we really just see him as our buddy.